हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंस फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 39।
शॉर्ट वीडियो स्टोरेज प्लेटफॉर्म फायरवर्क्स हैज स्ट्रक ए पार्टनरशिप विद एयरटेल टू पावर द टेलीकॉम शॉर्ट वीडियोस इनिशिएटिव। एज पार्ट ऑफ द डील, एयरटेल फ्लैगशिप ऐप एयरटेल थैंक्स विल शोकेस 30 सेकंड वर्टिकल वीडियोस फ्रॉम फायरवर्क ऑन इट्स एप्लीकेशन। Facebook announces steps to protect state elections in India. Facebook said it also continues to closely partner with election authorities, including setting up a high priority channel to remove content that breaks its rules or against local law after receiving valid legal orders. Unifor Technology, a startup using artificial intelligence to improve an enterprise's customer service calls that have raised $140 million in Series D funding. Led by Palo Alto-based Sorison Capital Partners, along with the participation from new investors Serena Capital, Sanabil Investment and Cisco Investments. Fujitsu Consulting India enabling the internal digital transformation process for Fujitsu. The Indian unit with over 4,500 people is working on various areas, systems and process integration to identifying technology areas where it can only play a leading role and collaborating with global items on solving customer platform. Digital technology company To The New has announced a permanent work from home option for its employees, internally referred to as a Newers. The decision came as a result of the company's successfully work from home run during the lockdown without any impact on business, community and client deliveries. HCL Technologies, India's largest IT service provider, has won a multi-year contract from global Tier 1 automotive supplier Tenneco Industries for integrated application development, modernization and operative service contract. As part of the engagement, HCL will help Tenneco enhance their IT simplification, modernization and transformation journey while keeping to reduce technical complexities and support the global IT application portfolio. Education tech leader Byju's has raised around 3,328 crores, that is about $460 million, as part of its ongoing Series F round, led by MC Global Educational Investment Holdings. India's top pharma major in talks to buy PharmaCrack. The digital platform will provide the technological backbone to companies looking to build their own online B2B marketplace and eventually an online pharmacy. HealthPlix land $13.5 million funding led by Lightspeed. HealthPlix provide electronic medical record software to medical practitioner. It also give them clinical decision support and generates e-prescriptions. Substack raises $65 million in Andersen Howard's led funding round. Substack said it would use a fresh capital to help funding its financial program for writers, growing a team of writers and bolster its subscription-based publishing model. RBI extends deadline for new guidelines on auto payments of bills subscriptions to September 30. For recurring payments above Rs 5000, banks are required to send one-time password to customers as per the new guidelines. E-commerce giant Amazon has acquired Bengaluru-based Purple at a time when digitizing small offline retailers is being seen as crucial for winning in India's fast-growing online retail sector. Hawaii has announced its financial report for last year, where it revealed its modest growth of 3.2% of net profits in 2020. The company even addressed the recent rumors regarding it working on building its own car, which it said again it is not the case. As per the Chinese tech giant, the company is working on smart connected vehicles, but it is not building its own car, rather it will be helping other automobile manufacturers in building smart connected vehicles. India is planning on offering more than $1 billion to each semiconductor-based firm that set up its manufacturing facility within the country. The news arrives as the government seeks to strengthen its electronic supply chain and build on its existing smartphone assembly industry. Payment app MobiQuick came under the scanner on Monday after a security researcher claimed that the data of 3.5 million users were put up for a sale on the dark web. The researchers claim that the sensitive information of 3.5 million users that was put on the dark web for sale includes KYC details, address, phone numbers, Aadhaar card data, and other details of the users. Several users have reportedly spotted their personal data on the dark web link that been circulated on the internet. Foxconn is one of the Apple's biggest suppliers, is the largest company to be affected by the worldwide chip shortage. It warned on Tuesday that the company expects a 10% decline in exports due to the global computer chip shortage. Google is releasing new features for the Google Maps that includes the maps highlighting the journey that generate the lowest carbon footprint using mainly traffic data and road inclines. The new features are a part of Google's commitment to fight climatic change. Google is also introducing Live View, which is powered by a technology called Global Localization, which uses AI to scan tens of billions of street view images to understand your orientation. If you are catching a plane or a train, Live View can help you find the nearest elevator, escalators, your gate, platform, baggage claim, check-in counters, ticket office, restrooms, ATMs, and more. Arrows and accompanying directions will point you the right way. Google is launching a new app called Stack that can scan your documents. The app is developed by Google Area 120 team, an in-house incubator that develops experimental projects. The app is available now for Android in the US, while there are no news if it will come in iOS or any other countries. Gokey and Encore, a publisher of OG Game founder, Vishal Gondal is in a bit of trouble as he has been summoned by the police in Faridabad over post against Real Money Gaming. Gondal has been posting about the difference between the video games and the real money gaming, which is, according to him, is a gambling. The case against Gondal has been filed by individuals who are claiming defamation, loss of revenue, and hurting of religious sentiment, as a result of which is summoning by the police on April 5th. As the COVID-19 pandemic wakes on, a lot of events in 2020 had to obviously be cancelled or had to moved online. From E3, Comic-Con to even various DC showcases, the internet was where it was at for almost all of 2020. Well, it looks like that trend is carrying on Apple's WWDC 2021, as announced to be as an online-only event. Just like last year, the conference will be moved to be an online-only event. Apple WWDC is set to start on June 7th and ending on June 11th. Various reports have stated that we could be seeing new versions of iOS, iPadOS, macOS, tvOS, and watchOS. Apple typically revealed a ton of new software updates during this time, so we should be expecting something substantial to be revealed in a statement to the press. ARM held a Vision Day event at which it teased details about its upcoming ARM version 9 architecture. The shorter version expects a massively altered security landscape, along with the improvements to vector math, which in turn means improvement in machine learning and artificial intelligence and digital signal processing, among other applications. Telegram has become one of the best Android messaging apps in the recent years in a part of security. If you don't know how to encrypt your chats in Telegram, you are missing it out. Since our phones are where we do the most of our communicating, privacy and security is becoming more important in our daily lives. You might have one of the most secure Android phones on the market, but that won't help if you don't secure the messages you are sending. While Telegram uses high level of encrypting on its platform, gentle messages are secured by server-client encryption. And if you trust Telegram, this is great. However, if you want to protect your messages from the platform too, messages in secret chats are protected by client-to-client, also known as end-to-end encryption. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.